everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Both quarterbacks have reliable tight ends they know they'll be able to count on to make plays. It's Rudolph's Vikings going up against Olsen's Panthers. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, with a beautiful skyline towering just to the right of us, you get a look inside Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte, North Carolina. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Minnesota Vikings. Hello again, everybody. I'm Brandon Godden here in the booth. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And you know, Charles, Larry took a moment to highlight a couple of the tight ends that we're going to see in this game. Both of these teams really look to get them involved in the offense early and often, don't they?
And we continue to see in the NFL how the tight end is becoming more and more of a highlighted position. Some of these guys can flex out like wide receivers. A lot of them can come inside, block as well as catch passes. He's exactly right. Tight end. That's a position we'll continue to follow as this game unfolds.
Fozzie Whitaker now on the return. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Cam Newton to the Carolina Panthers coming off a divisional loss last week to the New Orleans Saints, 31-21. So Newton and company, Charles, now at 8-4, and in that game, 183 yards, two touchdowns for Mr. Newton. What do you make of where they're at right now?
Tough spot. And the only reason I say that, doesn't look bad, right? They're only a game behind the Saints, but the Saints beat them head-to-head twice. So that really increases the lead that the Saints have in the NFC South. For Carolina, it's just a matter of consistency on offense. One week they look like a juggernaut. The next week they look a little more average, a little more pedestrian. That makes it hard on a very good defense that they have to make sure they hold people down.
On first down, it's Newton. To Shepard, complete over the middle. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now Camp, and oh, right away he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Now Newton. And it's hauled in by Ed Dixon. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. The man who threw for the only 2 touchdowns in the game last week and their win over Atlanta, Case Keenum, leading out the Minnesota Vikings. And Charles, you had that game, Vikings-Falcons. Minnesota, they've now won 8 straight.
And they're doing it on defense, as you might expect. Their head coach, Mike Zimmer, former defensive coordinator, they held the high-flying Atlanta Falcons to 9 points. But Case Keenum's the story of this team. I think what gets lost is how well they're playing on offense. Case Keenum isn't nursing an offense through this season. He is guiding it, in some ways carrying it, 25 of 30, 227, the two touchdowns you noted, was 13 of 13 in the second half, and hit some really key throws down the stretch to carry Minnesota to another win.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4. Let's take a look here at the offense for Minnesota.
For a lot of people, there are pros and cons to playing close to home in the NFL, but for Adam Thielen, it's nothing but pros. Grew up not too far from the Twin Cities, loves being a Viking, and is a really dependable third down receiver.
Second down following the run. On play action, it's Keenum. And he's got the hookup here. It's Kyle Rudolph. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Meanwhile, we will not get another play as time will run out on this first quarter. Nothing, nothing, our score. We're back to Uptown Charlotte after this timeout.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Vikings holding the football, and they've got it here with a first down. It's Murray, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Keenum throwing on second. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. Touchdown, Vikings! Stephon Diggs, 46 yards. And the Vikings are able to strike for 6.
That drive was quick and impressive. Almost like they had somewhere else they needed to be after the game.
Forbath on for the extra point. He's got it, and the Vikings take a 7-0 lead. So that drive, 4 plays, and it all culminates in a touchdown for Minnesota. Forbath out to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt, they're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
They go play action with Stewart. Now Newton. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, Charles, let's shift gears. I've got to ask you about what's going on in the AFC West.
Do you?
Do you really? I have no idea.
I mean, no,
Kansas City's lost four straight. Denver's lost eight straight. What's going on?
We'd all love to know, wouldn't we? Because I don't know how you felt about it, because I won't put words in your mouth, but I feel like the consensus around the country was this is the best division in the NFL.
Yeah.
Three teams potentially could go to the playoffs. Yet, as you noted, Kansas City's an absolute free fall. Oakland's on a nice little run right now. They've gotten themselves back into it. They're tied with Kansas City. And the Chargers are also tied with them at the top, all 6-6. And many think they're the hottest ticket. Forget tiebreakers right now. This division will work itself out. Oakland, Kansas City play next week. LA, Kansas City play on Saturday, December the 16th. And Kansas City plays at Denver, and Oakland plays at L.A., 12:31, New Year's Eve.
Throwing on third down, Newton. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Here's Michael Pilardi now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Well, nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. The Vikings now heading on to the field. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up two touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Down throw, Keenum to the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. That throw good for four. It's second down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, add that play to his resume reel, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big time penetration, and throw people for losses.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jarek McKinnon. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Ryan Quigley, fifth-year man from Boston College, in to punt it away. Back deep is Kalen Clay. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. And the Panthers coming out now.
This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
And tough starting field position here. First and 10, Newton. Throw left side is taken in by Stewart. And he'll be just shy of the 20 at the 19 as he goes out of bounds. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Second down, here's Newton. He hits Stewart in the flat. And down he'll go at the 25. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaunt alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout. And now we're set to get going. Now the offense lining up first and 10.
Watch tight, tight end right. Watch tight, tight end right. Set,
ready. Out of the gun, Newton. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Newton now to throw. And Olsen over the middle. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Newton. And his throw here is incomplete. The intended target that time, Brenton Burson. And it's third and short.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And the Vikings with an extra defender in the secondary on third.
Playing coverage here.
Again, Newton. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Here's Murray now as they run it to start the drive. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. So we hit halftime with our visitors, the Vikings, taking the lead to the locker room. As we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both the Panthers and the Vikings are not doing much on the ground, and it's easy to see why that would play into this low-scoring game. We'll have to see if either team gets it going on the ground in the second half. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Vikings now late in the first. Rudolph by himself here. Later on the drive, and he ends up at their own 49-yard line. Diggs is able to make the catch in traffic. And 46 yards later, he's going in for the score. Panthers take over late in the second. Hunter's got the sack here. This one ends up as a loss of six. So that's a wrap for us. We'll head back now to Bank of America Stadium for the start of the second half.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. To return, here comes Marcus Sherrills. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they'll go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
Obviously, a big play was needed, and you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
Keenum now on first down. Looking for his tight end, Rudolph, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Thomas Davis. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
From the 50, Newton. A dump off here to Stewart. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll lead here to a third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker. Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. He came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
To the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter of play. Now a first down throw for Newton. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Well, pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football. Back to the air, Newton on second down. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. It'll be a gain of 9, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. Here we go, 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. They'll try and run it. Here's Stewart. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. He loses 4, and it brings up 4th. Down 7, and they've got to go for it here on 4th down. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. 1 score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he finds a man, it's Olsen. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26. He'll look to throw. And caught left side, Olsen. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the completion. 2nd and 10. Back to throw. And he's got room. And avoids the contact by sliding. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. 1st down now, but the clock continues to move. He's back to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down. They'll look to throw. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Call it a 3-yard gain. And it'll be 3rd down. Cam trying to rally his guys to the line as quick as he can. Back to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Linval Joseph in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. Throwing is Newton. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. So they finally get their first trip to the red zone, and it ends with nothing.
And that's what I'm going to focus on with you, because you teed it up really well. Finally get to the red zone. So it's got to be a little bit of frustration because they haven't moved the ball as well as they wanted to all game. Now they get there, but we got to go for it because we don't know if we can get back here again. We don't know how many opportunities because they've been sputtering a little bit.
Absolutely. At this stage in the second half, to get there and not get it for the first time, Tom. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Oh, not running. Keenum wants to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
The Panthers are going to take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Whoa, shifty! Whoa! It'll be a 44-yard punt, six on the return. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. Now they do indeed get the timeout, so all is not lost. They'll have a chance for one final heave to the end zone. One last throw here for Newton. And for right side here, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.